mighty name, and all others welcome in Jesus' name. Now, let us bow our head and let us pray in Jesus' name. Mighty Father, our God and our Savior, we come before you, Jehovah, to give you all the glory and to praise you, for there is none like you, Jehovah. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for this day that you have made. Thank you, Father, for your grace, for your sufficient grace that you have given us. Thank you, Lord, for this day that you have been with us from morning even to this night, Jehovah. All the glory we give unto you, Jesus. Now, Lord, in this time, oh God, in this very moment, your people, your children, they are tuning, oh God, everywhere in the world of the world. Lord, I glorify your name. I pray, Jehovah, that I might not speak, but you will speak in me in Jesus' name. Let them not see me, Jehovah. Lord, I humble before you, before their presence, before you, Jehovah God, knowing it is by your grace, by your favor, by your presence, Lord, that you may use my tongue, use my spirit, Lord, that I may speak to your people in the name of Jesus Christ. Mighty Father, every spirit of confusion, every spirit of going against your word, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. I silence every voice, deceiving voice, every deceiving voice, interruption voices, every voice of distracting their heart, carrying their heart with thought, with chaos. Lord, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. And I pray, Lord, your presence to capture their mind, to capture their heart, that they may understand in the name of Jesus. I welcome you, precious Jesus, over the network, oh God. Welcome and cover the network, cover the transmission, cover the streaming by the blood of Jesus. And I pray that, Lord, you will awaken the many, Jehovah, and you reach to many for the glory of the Lord Jesus Christ. Mighty Father, we are here to speak to hear your word, to be transformed, oh God, and to be healed. In the name of Jesus, we do pray and even believe. Somebody say amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Now, today, I want us to read or to know about the curses. I want to teach about curses, breaking curses. Where, as a Christian who is born again, when you come to Jesus Christ, there is something that need to be done. There are many people who have come to Jesus by just believing that Jesus is the Lord, and they have seen that it is over with them. Believing Jesus Christ, it is not over. It is not finished. Being a Christian, it is not finished. You need to seek for deliverance. You need to seek for deliverance. You need to break down the curses. Many people who are still Christian, many people who are still born again, they do have curses. And those curses is what I want to speak about today, so that we may be free. Why Jesus Christ came? The reason why Jesus Christ came, he came to set us free. He came to destroy the work of the devil. He came to break down all the altars of the devil, and he came to destroy, to cast away all the curses and to give us a blessing. But we must seek for that blessing. We must seek for that blessing, not for that curse. We must seek God in order that he may break all those curses. So the reason why Jesus Christ came, he came as a savior, to save us from the curses, to save us from all evil, to deliver us. For he said that I came to set free the captives. I came to set free the captives. That is the reason why Jesus Christ came. And seeing today that even in the churches, people, women, even men, they are still serving God, but they are serving God with his demonic spirit. They are serving God with curses. They are serving God with still curses. How can you serve God when you are still in chain? How can you serve God when you are still in under curses? Serving God, then afterward you go to hell. Serving God, then afterward the devil attacks you. So the time has come for us to be delivered. The time for us, for each and every of us to be set free. Because the truth that I will preach today, the truth that we shall run here, shall set us free in the name of Jesus. It is about breaking curses that I have seen, that when you get born again, The journey does not end there. You need to break the curses. You need to be set free. You need to seek for deliverance. Because after all, I have seen that in my journey with the Lord Jesus Christ and even with the sheep who have been coming. Somebody will receive Jesus Christ today. Then we baptize him tomorrow. Then after one year, that man or woman will go back to the world. Why? Because there are still curses. There are still spirits. She or he was not delivered. Yes, he was baptized. Yes, she or he received Jesus, but she or he did not get free from satanic powers. There were curses. There were chains that was pulling him. There was evil spirit, and those evil spirit after a while, they backslide him. They will take him to the world. So that is why it is very important for each and every of us to be delivered. It is very important for each and every one to break all the curses and to be disconnected from everything that may be hindering your life, hindering your health, hindering your spiritual life, hindering even your financial life, hindering your body, anything that may be standing against you. To take away your peace, to take away your blessing, should be disconnected today in the name of Jesus. You should not live with curses. You should not live with those things, with the evil spirit. The time has come for you to be delivered, and you will be delivered after knowing the truth. Now, I want to speak about the breaking of curses, the type of curses. What is a curse? What is a curse? A curse is a bad wish. A curse is a bad wish. It is a bad wish or a disaster. It is a negative thing that will be spoken by somebody. That is a curse. A curse is a bad wish. You see, opposite of a curse is a blessing. We have the blessing and we also have the curse. And so, when we can define the word curse or what is a curse, it is actually a bad wish. A bad wish that comes from the kingdom of darkness, that comes from even men, you see? Or you can say it is a solemn uterus. It is a solemn uterus, an uterus, a spoken uterus, intended to evoke supernatural power, to inflict human, you see? To inflict human or to punish somebody. So we can say a curse is a spoken word intended to invoke supernatural power, supernatural powers or demonic spirit or spirit power to inflict human or to punish somebody. You see? So curses, they are spoken word which are intended to invoke, they invoke spirit. When somebody speaks a curse, he invokes a spirit to go to follow after you. He invokes a spirit, or he commands a spirit to come and punish you, to come and torture you, to come and kill you. That is what we mean by a curse. There are many types of curses. There are many types of curses if only we can understand them. There are many types of curses if only we can understand them. Number one, I want you to note down, to write down. Number one curses. It is cultural or traditional curses. Cultural or traditional curses. You see, those are curses which come from tradition or from your culture. From your background. You see, there is somewhere in the Bible, the word of God, that says that since when you are born, your mother did not separate you from the umbilical. Now, go back and be separated. That is what the word of God says. Go back and be separated from where you are born. You see, that those are curses. Curses, those traditional curses or those cultural curses, they are traditional curses from where you are born. Where you are born, the tribe you are born, your mother, your father, who was your father, who was your mother, who was your grandfather, who was your great-grandfather. Those are traditional curses that come from your background. And those traditional curses, they bound people that they cannot continue in life. You hear people, they are dying.
You hear that there is miscarriage. You hear that there is about madness. Madness in the family. Lunaticism. Or epilepsy. Epilepsy diseases. Certain diseases that repeat themselves in the tradition or in your culture or in your family. You see? Those are a result of cultural or traditional curses. And traditional curses, they strengthen themselves through the blood pouring, through the bloodshed. When people shed blood, or when your grandfather or your grandmother, when he shed the blood at the past, they used to shed blood. When they were shedding blood, they were invoking. When they were slaughtering the animal, they were invoking certain word upon that family. If your family name is whoever John, they were pronouncing that curse or invoking that through this bloodshed, the family of John, the family of your grandfather or your grandmother, that family or that lineage will be protected by that blood or will be under that blood, will be under that covenant. And when they say that when you go against it, there is a curse. So when we believe Jesus Christ, those things we come. When we believe Jesus Christ, those things they comes against us because we have denied them, we have renounced them. So they wage a war with you. They wage a war with you, and they start manifesting themselves. For they say that there would be no other covenant, but when you receive Jesus, there is two covenants. So those two covenants will be fighting together. So that is why you see that there will be death. There will be certain death, strange death happening in your family. Strange miscarriage, that when a woman, when all women or when all the sisters, when they get married, they must divorce. They must divorce. They must go through polygamy. Other, they must miscarry. Other, they must go through certain things in the marriage, you see, or other, they must be a polygamy woman. Look at that. Why? Because there is those curses that were following in your family, that were following in the lineage, in that lineage. Look at that, in that lineage. And it was formed due because of that blood that poured, the bloodshed. Because the Bible says, let us turn in the word of God, in the book of Hebrew, in the book of Hebrew 9:18. In the book of Hebrew 9:18, let us turn so that you may understand that those traditional whereby you used to slaughter, those traditional whereby our forefathers, they used to slaughter, they used to pour blood. That blood is not like water, the water that goes down. Blood is life, and blood, every blood that pour, it has a meaning. Every blood that is shed, it has a covenant. You will hear what the word of God says in the book of Hebrew. Let us read in the book of Hebrew in Jesus' mighty name. In the book of Hebrew, that is where we are reading. So that we may understand according to the scripture what the word of God is saying. Hebrew 9:18. The Bible says this. Hebrew 9:18. The Bible says this. Therefore, not even the first covenant was dedicated without the blood. Hear that. Therefore, not even the first covenant was dedicated without the blood. For when Moses had spoken every precept to all people according to the law, he took the blood of the calves and goats with water, scarlet wools. Look at that. Note this. He say that, for therefore, even in the first covenant was dedicated, therefore, not even the first covenant was dedicated without blood, or no covenant without blood. That is what it means, that no covenant without blood. When you slaughter an animal, or when you slaughter anything in your family, anything, doing a ceremony, tradition ceremony, they used to do traditional ceremony of circumcision, whereby they slaughter, ceremony of marriage, ceremony of the death, they used to slaughter. When they were pouring that blood, they were sealing a covenant with the ancestral spirits of the dead, because they are not the spirit of God. They used to be the spirit of the dead, and those are demon incarnate, pretending to be their grandfather, pretending to be their grandmother, pretending to be their wrong time grandmother who died, or father who died, their spirit, their demonic spirit incarnating themselves in form of those people who died. So when they see through the pouring of the blood, that means there is a curse that has been mentioned there, and those are the invoking those things. They backfire in the generation. They backfire in the children, because your father, your mother, your grandfather, he was associated there, and when he was associated, he gave himself. So he gave out all his children. He gave all his children, all his lineage, all his seed, and you are the seed of that grandfather. So you see, those demons, they still hunt. They still hunt people. They hunt people even in dreams, saying that, oh, my grandmother is chasing me. My grandfather is chasing me. Those are curses. They are demonic spirit. They are a spirit of ancestor. We need to disconnect them, because if we don't disconnect them, that is where you end up. You hear people, oh, there is suicide, oh, there is certain death, oh, there is strange death that has occurred, oh, people, they cannot marry in that family, women, they cannot marry there, and if they marry, they marry to be the second wife. There is epilepsy diseases or strange diseases, there is madness, and certain things that happen in that generation. Why? Because there is curses. Those are curses that we call cultural curses or traditional curses that happen in the old time. And those things, if we ignore them, they come and they attack our children. We need to disconnect our children. We need to disconnect our life. We need to disconnect from those curses of traditional, curses of grandfather, curses of grandmother. You see, those are curses. We need to disconnect them. Those curses that came as a result of celebration, of rituals. There were certain rituals that were done. You see, even those people in the old times, some of them, they were witches. And so when you don't separate yourself from those things, you get punished by God. Why? You get punished by God because you have bowed down to other God. Let us turn to the word of God, and you will come to hear what God says. You see, if you have ever gone to witchcraft, if you have ever partake in any satanic ritual, Either praying with the candles, or either wizard, and all those war-off, and all those things that we call witchcraft, either you have ever associated yourself, when you come out of that religion, or when you come out from that witchcraft or that cult, there is always curses, because they say that you cannot enter into the kingdom of darkness and come out that way. When the day you will come out of that on that altar, there will be a curse. So those curses still follows you, because they are real. It is something that you had made a covenant that I will worship here, that I will serve this God. So when you come out of those gods or come out of those covenant, there is curses. You hear people say, oh, when you enter here, if you ever move here, or if you ever deny, you will die. If you ever go against our law, or if you ever confess this secret religion, secret cult, secret sect, you will die. So you see, they were invoked. There was word that was invoked. There were a bad wish was spoken, and when you came out of that thing, that sect, those curses, they followed you, because it is an invoke. They follow you because they were spoken and you have acted. So you have broken the vow, you have broken the promise of those witches. You see, that is why we need to separate ourselves from those generational curses. Let us read in the Bible, the word of God, in the book of Deuteronomy 5. We are reading in the book of Deuteronomy 5. So that you may continue to understand why we should not ignore. Because sometimes we as Christians, we relax so much, seeing that when we were saved, nothing happened. So we say that it is finished, and we ignore some of the things. There are some of the things, unless you confess them, you cannot be forgiven. Unless you confess to Jesus, they cannot be broken. So that the Bible says,
That's why the Bible says, confess your sin so that you may be healed. And the Bible says, those that confess their sin, they will be healed. But if you don't confess your sin, you cannot be healed. Let us read in the book of Deuteronomy 5, so that you may know that there are those generation curses that they follow. And those things, they follow people, they follow their lineage, they follow generation after generation. They follow generation after the generation. That is why we cannot ignore. We cannot ignore anything. Yeah? If you want to be delivered, you cannot ignore anything in this hour. Hallelujah. Let us read. Reading in the book of Deuteronomy 5. Deuteronomy 5. In Jesus' name. Deuteronomy 5. There are 9. Deuteronomy 5. Hallelujah. And I am reading Deuteronomy. Let me read in Jesus' name. Deuteronomy 5, 9. Let us start 8. The Bible says, you shall not make for yourself a carved image, any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Look at that. You shall not bow down to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord God, I am jealousy God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon children to the third, to the fourth of those who hate me, but showing mercy to thousand to those who love me and keep my commandment. Look at that. He say, you shall not make yourself a carved image. Were our forefathers, did they not make these idols? They worship idols. Our grandfathers, our grandmother, they worship idols. They were worshiping Satan. They were worshiping Satan through carved images, carved things, saying it is God. They worshipped even the mountain. They worship even the sea. Some even worship the stone, and other they worship the tree itself. Back in your culture, back in your lineage, back in your family, back in your tribe, look at how they used to worship. Look at that. Now understand, the Bible says, look at this. You shall not bow to them nor serve them. For I, the Lord your God, I am jealousy God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children to the third and fourth generation to those who hate me. Look at that. That visiting the iniquities of the fathers. So God will revisit. God will revisit. He will revisit the sin of our fathers, the sin of our grandfather, the sin of our grandmother. God will revisit them. And when he revisit them, he say that upon the children to the third and to the fourth, to those and even to those of who hate me. Look at that. Upon the third generation, the fourth generation, God will revisit himself. He will revisit. He will punish you, but he's punishing because of the sin of your grandfather, the sin of your grandmother, the sin of your mother, the sin that was committed in your background, in your tribe. The traditional curses, those are they that follow you. And so God say that because of that, he say, for I am the Lord, I am jealousy God, visiting iniquity of the father upon the children to the third and to the fourth generation of those who hate me. Look at this, that because of that, God will punish. God will bring a curse. So you see, unless we repent and separate ourselves from those generational curses, we cannot be free. We will always be wondering, why are our children going away? Why are our marriage not working? Why are we not growing? Why are we not maturing? Because there are things that need to be broken on your life. There are things that need to be destroyed. There are curses that may be following your life. That's why we need to be disconnected. We need to be disconnected and to be separated from those things so that you may be set free. Hallelujah. Look at that. Another curses number two. There are curses that we call generational curses. There are curses that we call generational curses. Now we have come away from, about the traditional curses. Now we are in generational curses. Those generational curses, they follow people from generation to generation. Generational curses, they are curses that were made by the grandfather. They were curses or they were things that were made by the grandfather, by grandmother.
And those generation curses, they are inheritors. They are like inheritors. Generational curses, some are even demonic spirit. They are demonic spirit. They are evil spirit. And those evil spirit, they are in mission. They are in mission. You see, like how we used to run in a marathon. In a marathon, there is a game of marathon whereby people used to run with a stick, holding stick like this. That you give the you run, then you give this one the stick. You run, then you give this one the stick. That is how generational curses work. That is why how those generational curses, those generational spirit, they work like that. Your grandfather, when he died, he those curses, they went and somebody inherited them. You may inherit them through the name. You may inherit them through the name. That's the same thing that he was doing. You will find yourself that you are doing them. What your grandfather was doing, you find yourself that you are doing. What your grandfather was doing, you will find that you are doing. Why? Because there are generational curses that are following you. And when those generational curses are following you, you know you cannot increase, you cannot multiply, you cannot be fruitful. Your things cannot go well. Your life cannot go well. Why? Because there are generational curses. So, what your grandfather was doing, what your grandmother was doing, or what your auntie was doing, because you are named after your auntie, you find yourself that now you are inheriting the same spirit like of your auntie by name. Generation curses, they come through name. They can come through name, the name that you are named with. Like now, there are many people who are named in our country. Some people are named a name which is an invoke, a name which is a word. You know, every name, it is a spirit. Name is a spirit. Name is a spirit, I repeat again. Every word has a spirit. So if your name is called, maybe somehow, let us say, if your name, there are people who are called Wanjohi. There are people who are called Wanjohi. Wanjohi in English, in translated in English, means people who drink beer or drunkard. They are called Wanjohi. There are people who are called Wanjohi, and that is a name. There are other people who are called. So every word, every name that you are called, no, it is an act. It is a spirit. So that name that you have, it is a spirit that you have. You see, it's like somebody who is called goodness. Goodness. No, the word goodness is not just a name. It is goodness. It's the spirit of goodness. So you find that there is goodness. Goodness should be following you because you are called goodness. You see, that is what I want to mean. So there are generational curses. There are generational curses that are inherited. They are inherited through name. Your name, the name that you are called. Your grandfather, your grandmother was named after you. Maybe you are named after your uncle. Look at your uncle, the behavior of your uncle. Look what is happening in your life. Ask yourself, who was that? Why my mother named me my this name? Who was that person? How was his character? Because those generational curses or generational spirit, they inherit, or they inherit after name. So they inherit the name. When you are born, you begin taking the destiny of the name of the owner of the name. Taking the destiny of the owner of the name. If he was a drunkard, you become a drunkard. If he was a polygamy, you become a polygamy. If he was a thief, you become a thief. If he was very poor, he was cursed. He was a man who was very poor, that he was cursed, that he cannot do something with the money, or he can not do something. He cannot prosper. You'll become like him. Look at that. That what may be eating you, what may be torturing you, it is your background, what your name. Did you separate yourself from the curses of your name? Look at that. So if your grandfather, or if your uncle, your auntie, the owner of the name, if he was a person of bitterness, a person of anger, you will find yourself that you inherited his spirit. You inherited his spirit of anger. You see, his spirit of anger. Why? Because name, they do have spirit. Which spirit is working in your name? Which spirit is working against your name or under your name? Because your name is under a spirit. Your name is under an act, is under an invoke, is under a spoken word. You see? That is why we need to know the truth, and for the truth, we need to know the truth, and the truth will set us free. Look at that. You see, in the Bible, God, when Jacob, when he fought with God so much, Jacob was given the name Israel. He was transformed the name Israel. Why? And Israel means he was blessed. He was blessed. By that name, he was blessed. People of God, that is when God calls you, some people may be given another name. Why? Why another name? Because that name used to be used in the spiritual kingdom somewhere. Or that name is named after certain creature or certain thing in the kingdom of darkness. So when you come in the kingdom of the light, you must change those names. Or if not, you must disconnect yourself. You see, the naming, this is the traditional of naming. Those who did the naming, or back to our traditions, back to our culture, back to our forefathers, they were naming people after their own name because they wanted the same spirit in them to rest in their children. So they wanted to do a spirit inheritance, a curse inheritance. That is why they said, oh, my children, you will name them after me. Name them, and they say, if you don't name them, something bad will happen. Why? Because there is curses. There are spirits that are transferred through the name. So they want you to be, they want those spirits to remain in your generation or in your family forever. Look at that. That is why we need to separate ourselves and to destroy everything that may be working against your life in order that you may be set free. Free from all bondage, free from all curses, free from all generation curses, and name the inheritors of the spirit, inheritors of diseases, inheritors of work, of destiny, that maybe you are living in another man's destiny. Look at that. Where you are right now, it is not your destiny. That is not the destiny maybe you would be living. You are living in the destiny of your father, of your grandfather, of the destiny of your auntie. Because of the name, because of something that was spoken, living in another man's life. Look at that. He died long ago, but he still walk, he still act, he still do whatever he wants to do through you. You are being used to complete, to fulfill the mission of the dead and their ancestral spirits. We need to break down all those things in the name of Jesus Christ. There was a man in the Bible who was called Jabez. And the Bible said Jabez, that he cried to God to change him, that name Jabez. Because that name Jabez meant that painful. And he knew that this name Jabez would always be in tears. I would always be in tears. Look at that. I would always cry because of my name. So he cried to God, oh God, change me. This name, or else disconnect this name from tears, because I will live it in tear. I will live crying because of my mother. Because when he was born, his mother, he named him after the pain that he went through. Let us read. You see, some of the things, they may appear to you as if they are new things. They are new things. They are not new things. Let us read in the book of First Chronicle 4:9. The Bible says this. Now Jabez was more honorable than his brother, and his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bore him in pain. Look at that. Because I bore him in pain. And Jabez called on God of Israel, saying, Oh, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory, that your hand would be with me and that you would keep me from all evil, that I may not cause pain. Look at that. He is telling God, he is praying God, that oh God, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory, that your hand would be with me and that you would keep me from all evil. Look at that I may not cause pain. So God granted him what he requested. Look at that. He cried to God and God changed his name. And God granted unto him that Jabez was fearing. That, oh God, because my name means pain. That I may not cause pain. I may not live in pain. Marriage of pain. Ministry of pain. Children of pain. Tears every day. Suffering, because of the name. So Jabez cried unto God, and God granted him what he requested, and God heard his prayer. Look at that. Very wonderful. That illustrates for us that paint a picture of what name is. That name are not just a name. You see, there are many people who just mention, get children, and they name them after name. I heard another day when Obama came in our country, those children that were born during the time of Obama, they were named after Obama. They were named after Obama. That, look at that. People naming others after a celebrity. Yeah? Other people naming their children after Rihanna, after Jay-Z, after Lil Wayne. Look at that. Naming your children after people, after Bob Marley. Huh? The same spirit that used to operate in those secular musicians or in those celebrity of the world. And you don't know their God. Some worship Illuminati. Some their God is Satan himself. And they are worshippers of the devil. Those names, they were given those names. Or like Michael Jackson. They were given those names so that they may tread. It is a name that have a covenant in the kingdom of darkness, that all people, when they hear about Jay-Z, when they hear about Beyonce, they will draw near to her. A name that is invoked curses and spare. Now you are naming your child Beyonce, naming your child Rihanna, naming your child after a certain celebrity, after a certain man. Look at that. You are endangering the life of your child. Because those generational curses, spirit, they will follow her. They will follow him. They will follow your child. Because they are spirits from him. You are idolizing that man. So you become, you name him after her, after him. Look at that. We need to be careful, my dear brother and my sister. We need to be careful. Because if you're not careful with names, if you are not careful with names, you may end up in the kingdom of darkness. You may end up even in hell. Because that name was of a certain satanist. And now you took his anointing. After those spirits, they came after you and they took. You know, demon, they have authority because it is there. That name belongs to them. So it is an open door. So you cannot say, I don't belong to you. But your name says that you belong to them. It is like an insurance arises that say that this race says that you belong to this company, your name after them. Look at that. That is why we need to separate ourselves from all those curses in Jesus' name. There was a time that I had attended a burial of a certain man of God. Now his father, the father of a certain man of God, my friend. And when I was there, there was something that was told, that was spoken, that man of God, when that man of God was born, his own father, he named that man of God, he named him after a certain pastor or after a certain man of God. Look at that. That when his father named him, he named him after a certain man of God. Because he named him after his pastor. He was his pastor. So he say, this child, I will name him after my own pastor, whom I know, a man of God. And when he named him, he did not know what will happen. Then after years, like 26 or like 30 years, that child that was named after that man of God, that anointing was in him. Even as he was growing, he was having that anointing. The way he acted, God was with him. Why? Because God also walked with him. Because as God was walking with Abraham, he will walk with Isaac. The same blessing will walk with him. So you see that the anointing of that man of God, or that name that was dedicated to God, now he has transmitted, or he has inherited that spirit from that man of God. And now that child, today, he is a man of God. He's a servant of God. He's a preacher. Why? Because he was named after a certain pastor, the pastor of his father. What if he was named after a satanist? Or he was named after a drunkard? Or after a prostitute? Or after somebody who is wicked? He would become wicked. There is power in a name. Do not ignore about names. Do not ignore about the names. There is power. We need to know the name. We need to know that truth for us to be set free. Look at that. So that is why some people, they are struggling today. Some struggling with the anger. Some struggling with the lust. Some they are struggling with the worldliness. Some they are struggling with the smoking, with the drunkenness, with the beer. Some they are struggling with women, because you are named after the womanizer. You are named after humanizer. Some you are named after the men, or some after the prostitution. So you find yourself you are not satisfied with one man. So it's like you want to go to other men. So there's a spirit that is working in you, but it's not by your own. It is by that name that you are named. That name, the owner was a prostitute. The owner was a polygamy. Maybe she was a woman who was a slave queen in those days. So we need to disconnect ourselves from all evil. All evil, from all curses in our life. Another curses. There are curses that we call curses of death. Death curses. There are death curses that comes in our life. Death curses. What are death curses? Those are the spirit of the dead. They are spirit of the dead. They are curses from the spirit of the dead. And those curses, they come when people, they do something. They do something. Maybe a celebration of the dead. Maybe a celebration with ancestors. That is when they connect their soul with those spirits of the dead. There are people who do the death anniversary. The death anniversary. Whereby after a certain time, they go to that burial and to the grave, and they put flower. Who do you give that flower? Those flower. Somebody died long ago, and you pick up a flower and you go to the grave to put to that grave. When you put that flower, you are connecting yourself with the spirit of the dead. Why? Let us read in the book of Mark 12:27. Mark 12:27. You will understand that God is not of the dead. Mark 12. So when you do certain things, know that there is a consequence. There is a consequence of doing certain things that you do. Let us read Mark in the book of Mark. Mark 12. Mark 12:27. Mark 12:27. The Bible says this, Mark 12:27, and I am reading right now. The Bible says this, hear this. He is not the God of the dead, but the God of the living. You therefore greatly mistaken. Look at that. You are therefore greatly mistaken, for God is not the God of the dead. So when you go to the grave and saying, oh, I'm doing a death anniversary, which kind of spirit are you connecting with? Because that man or that woman, he or she died long ago. So you cannot give him. You yourself, you are a physical. You are not spirit. You are a physical. Giving a physical flower and putting at the grave. So who do you expect who will receive that flower? It is spiritual spirit. It is a spiritual being which will accept. When it accepts that flower, you will give it to the spirit of the dead. You will give it to the spirit of ancestors. You will give it to certain demons. You are invoking curses all by yourself. Spirit of death, spirit of suicide. You see, those are curses that they are that you are bringing in yourself. The Bible says also there is curses that comes when God had said that we should not speak or relate with the spirit of the dead. Spirit of the dead. So when you are going to the spirit, you're saying, oh, we are remembering the death anniversary. What you are doing, you are invoking certain spirit. You are calling certain spirit, and that celebration, it is offered to demons, not to God. The food, the whatever you do, it is offered to demons, not to God. And you awake those spirit. You awake the dead spirit, the spirit of the ancestors or demonic spirit. As I said earlier, they are demonic spirit which comes in form of those spirit, of those name, or those people who died, and then you start, they start appearing in your dream. They start calling you. You say, oh, my grandfather is calling me. I see somebody who died, he is calling me. Somebody who I knew, he died. What is there? What is the relationship between those that died and those who are alive? There's no relationship between the dead and between those who are alive. You see, when you die, there is a great valley whereby it is separated between the dead people and between the live people. The land of the living and the land of the dead. They don't mix. They don't mix. Like heaven and earth, they don't mix. So why are they calling you the spirit of the dead? They are calling you the dream. You need to separate yourself from the dead curses, from the dead spirits that may be following you. Let us read the book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 18. Let us read Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 18. We are reading in the book of Deuteronomy 18:11. Some of the things, unless we read the scripture, we cannot believe. We cannot believe. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Hallelujah. Let us read. Sorry. 18. Deuteronomy 18:11. We are reading Deuteronomy 18:11. Hallelujah. The Bible says this. 18:11. And I am reading. Let us start 9. When you come in the land which the Lord your God is giving you, you shall not learn to follow the abomination of those nations. Look at that. There shall not be found among you anyone who make his son or his daughter pass through the fire, or one who practices witchcraft. Look at that. Or soothsayer, or one who interprets omens, interpret the star, or a sorcerer, or one who conjures the spells. Conjuring the spells, or a medium, or a spiritist, or one who calls up the dead. A spiritist, it is a path, it is those people who speak with the dead. They speak with the spirit of the dead, saying, oh, your grandfather has spoken to me, your mother who is dead has spoken to me. Look at that. They are called spiritism, spiritist, or one who calls up the dead. Calls up the dead. We should not relate with the dead or one who calls up the dead. So when you go to death anniversary, giving a flower to somebody who died, you are doing those things. You are as a medium, as spiritism, the one who speak with the dead, or one who calls up the dead. You are calling, you are awakening the dead. You are communicating with the dead through death anniversary and giving the flower. Perofsi, for all who do those things are abomination to the Lord. Look at that. You who do those things, you are abomination to the Lord. And because of those abomination, the Lord your God drives them out before you. Look at that. That is a curse. The Lord your God drives you, he drives them out before you. You shall be blameless before the Lord your God. For those nations which you will dispossess, they listen to soothsayers and diviners. But as for you, the Lord your God has not appointed such for you. Look at that. You see, and those are the things that people do. You see, people today, Christian today, they are copying the Western country. They are copying the other people. How they used to do, now you want to do like them. Death anniversary. Halloween. What is heroin? Heroin is a celebration of the dead, whereby people put demonic mask of the dead, scaring mask, terrifying mask of fear. They celebrate, they communicate with the dead, with a zombie. Halloween, celebration of Halloween, that is invoking demonic spirit, spirit of death over your life. And if you have ever done Halloween, those things, you need to repent. You need to disconnect yourself from the spirit of the dead spirit. That is how it is. Because those things, when you do those things, that is an initiation. It is a demonic initiation whereby you enter through the celebration. You enter the celebration of the dead, the celebration of the dead, or in the kingdom of darkness, you enter through the celebration of Halloween, anniversary, speaking with the dead spirit, going to the mediums, going to witchcraft, and going to diviners, medium, koja, spares, interpret omens, you who go to interpret omens, so they say, witchcraft, practice of witchcraft, all those things, they are not good. All those things, they are not good, and they invoke spirit in your life. Look at that. And those things, they make you to curse God. And when you curse God, there is also a curse from God. Look at that. And they start appearing in your dreams. Why? Because you celebrated with the dead. A Christian is not a Christian who is born again should not relate himself with the dead. God is not of those who are dead, the spirit at the grave. No. If you see yourself dreaming with a certain person who is dead, and those people, some of them, they were not even born again. My dear brother and my sister, separate yourself, because there is death which is calling you. You are being called to serve, because they have a role. When they die, they go and they start serving in those other kingdoms. Hallelujah. So those are the spirit of death. That is the death curses. That is the death curses that I'm speaking about. And that death curses also come from even tattooing. When you do tattoo, according to the word of God in the book of Leviticus, the word of God in the book of Leviticus, is it Leviticus 19? 21. Let us look at that. You will see about tattoo. When you are doing tattoo, that also is invoking the curses of the dead. Death curses. You are invoking death curses. Let us read. All things must be established through the scripture. Yes, let us read Leviticus, where it speaks about tattoo. Leviticus 21:19. Leviticus, where it speaks about tattoo. Somebody help me to see that scripture. Leviticus 20. Hallelujah. Anybody help me with that verse as we continue? In the name of Jesus Christ. Anybody to help me with that scripture about tattoo? I'm forgetting. Hallelujah. You shall not do anything with the blood, nor shall you perceive divination sowing. Who is there who will help me with that scripture? Leviticus, thank you so much, Veronica and Luther Gosa. This is Leviticus 19. Yes, I am going around, I am revolving around this Leviticus 19. 1928. Yes, it is 28. Yes, thank you so much. The Bible says, you shall not make any cutting in your flesh for the dead, nor tattoo any mark on you. Or I am the Lord. Look at that. You shall not make any cutting in your flesh for the dead, nor tattoo any marks on you. I am the Lord. You shall not make any cutting in your flesh for the dead. So you see, tattooing yourself and even piercing yourself, cutting your body that have something to do with the dead. For he said, for the dead. It have something to do with the dead, the spirit of the dead. You see? That is why you see that even many people who draw tattoo, they draw tattoo of certain person who is dead. Some they draw even their father, their grandfather who is dead. Because tattoo and a piercing of the body, that is something that relates with the spirit of the dead. So it is an initiation. It is a covenant with the spirit of the dead. You see? Some they draw skeleton. Some they draw scary things that look like a dead thing. Huh? Like look like just the demonic things, the dead spirit. They put them. That is why God is telling us that we must separate ourselves from the dead spirit that is following our life in the mighty name of Jesus. You see? Another curse that I want to speak about, it is a curse that is called religious curses. They are things that we call religious curses. Religious curses, they are religious curses. They are curses from satanic people, witchcraft, witches, wizard, sorcery, even the false prophet. Those are religious curses. False prophet, they can also curse you. Or not even false prophet, but even even true prophets, they can also curse you when they are angry. When they become angry, or men of God, when they become angry, they can curse you. But for me, I cannot curse you because we are told to bless, not to curse. And if you curse somebody and he become mad and he failed to repent, you'll be accounted for the blood of that mad person, that person that you have cursed with your own word. You destroy his life, you will be accountable of his life. You see, we are speaking about the religious curses. Don't ever ignore religious curses. There are men of God who curse people. There are certain priests, certain prophet who curse people. You find that you are in a certain cult, you are in a certain church, you are in a certain man of God whereby you had said that you will fellowship together, you will not move there, but it comes a point that you left him after knowing that he was a false prophet. You left him, and when you left him, maybe you did a grudges with him. You did not leave him at peace. So you exchange some word and he cursed you and he said, oh, you will become scatter, you will scatter, you will go from there to there. And till today, you have been going from this to this. You have been jumping from church to church because of the word that he said to you. Some may not even know that when you just go out of that church, that man or that prophetess or that woman or that priest, he invokes some spirit, some demonic spirit. He invokes some word and say that person will be useless. He will be a useless Christian. He will never be established. He will die miserable. He will be poor. He will have poverty. He will die of poverty. Her marriage or his marriage will not prevail. You see, there are priests, there are people who invoke demons, who invoke or who invoke supernatural powers, who invoke curses upon you, and those curses, they follow you. Look at this. Remember, in the case of this prophet Elijah, is it Elijah or Elijah? Elijah, that prophet Elijah, let us say is prophet Elijah, because Elijah and Elijah, they are one in the spirit, they are same spirit, the same anointing operating. Now, when Elijah, the man of God, when he was insulted by those boys, by those youth, they insulted him. They made a fan out of him, and they started calling him all bald man, because he had a bald. And that man of God, that prophet, he invoked a curse upon them. And that invoking, that word that he said that they will die, he cast them. That curse, he cast them. A spirit entered an animal. That spirit will enter an animal. It entered a bear, and the bear out of nowhere came and devoured those boys. They were, I think, 49 or 40 something. those boy, imagine that spirit that invoked that curse that he said out of his heart. It is word that are uttered. It is word that are spoken when he is very angry. And when he spoke those word, he invoked a spirit of death. And a spirit of death will go and fulfill to that man that has been cursed. So do not pray with the curses. Curses from witches, curses from prophets, curses from pastors, curses from men of God, curses from women, curses, any curses that you hear from anybody, or religious curses, curses from satanism, witches, or even a false prophet, or whoever they are, the religious curses, do not ignore them, because it is an evil uterus. It is an evil, an invoking of demons of death, demons of torturing your life, demons of making you to suffer, demons of sickness. Some people have been just withdrawn those demons because of a curse that has been said. A curse and a spirit of accident will follow you. Accident, every time you go, accident. There's a spirit, somebody has mentioned a death spirit over your life. Somebody has cursed you. The witches can curse you. The witches and there are other these who we call wizard witches and wizard. There are other satanists, the other people who operated the marine kingdom. They can't curse you, so do not ignore them. You need to separate them. That is why we are taught by the word of God that to pray that no weapon that is formed against me shall prevail. So when you say that in the name of Jesus, you are breaking. No word that has been spoken against me shall prevail. So you break them, because there are evil curses, evil word that may be spoken over your children, over your business, over your marriage, over your children, over your life. Some people are crying today. Some people are crying. They have failure in their life, that they cannot do well in their marriage. They cannot do well in their business. When they start business, it corrupts. Because there are some curses that they spoke. Sometimes you may have hurted somebody, you may have wronged somebody. Like maybe you took something which belonged to another man, or you stole something, and the owner, when the owner realized that you have stolen his phone, you have stolen his money, he cursed and he said, "That man that has stolen me, I curse him that he will never succeed, he will never prosper." And that is what happens in your life, even today. Why? Because you got born again, but you did not break down those curses. You did not break that down those curses. You need to break them. You need to disconnect them through the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Some, they stole another husband of another woman. So you did adultery. And you broke the family of somebody. You took a man who was engaged to his wife, and you break their marriage. So that woman, she cursed you, and she said that woman that have broken my marriage, she will never prevail in her marriage. She will never prevail in her marriage. And those words, they are evil words that were spoken. It's a bad wish over your marriage until today, that now you are suffering because you broke a marriage of somebody. Look at that. There are things that, like those, that they go like that. You hear people saying that what you sow is what you reap. What you sow is what you reap. Because of the evil that you have done, you did it before. That thing you are reaping today, from the words of the things that you did, the people that you hurted, the people that you wronged, they cursed you. Now it cannot be well with you. Those are the things that we need to destroy them. We need to cut them off, to separate them, so that we may not die unmature. There are people who dies unmature, their family dies unmature. Unmature death, or we call them premature death, death that are not godly. You know, they are death that are godly, but how comes that people are dying when they are still young? He is not married, or if he is married,
his children are still young. Look at that. Unmatured death. Why, man? Matured death. Matured, unmatured death. 2 years death. With 2 years, 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years. No, 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 no. We need to know that there are things that we need to separate in our life. To separate in our life so that we may stand well in the name of Jesus Christ. Let me tell you, my dear brother, my sister, there is a story, and that is not just a story. It's something that is real. It is something that is real. There is a woman who was being interviewed on the channel, and that woman, where now she is being interviewed, she has a metal in her leg because she broke through accident, and she say that since there is a certain month, if it is March, that March, whenever that March will come, something evil will happen over her life. Either there will be an accident, either something evil will happen. She must pour blood, or her family, or in her family, something evil must happen during that period of month. You see? Because there are evil things that happen. There is a sacrifice and a pouring of blood. There were curses that were made that in this March, in every of this certain year, that the family must shed blood. Either a person will die, either they will get accident, either there will be miscarriage, either there will be suicide. You see, because there are curses that follows after people. My dear brother, my sister, do not fear what I'm telling you, because Jesus Christ has come. He came to set us free from the curses, and when he died at the cross, he took all our curses and he broke them. So you only need to believe, to confess them, and to do what we shall do here today, so that you may believe that they are broken in Jesus' name. Because that is why he came. And that is why the word of God is spoken. For the Bible says, the truth shall set you free. It is the truth that shall set you free in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Another curse is about sexual intercourse curse. There is a curse that comes as a result of sexual intercourse. There are many sexual intercourse. If we can say it is unsafe sex, or sex before marriage, sex with an animal, sex with a family, across a family, that is incest. Sex between man and man, sex between woman and woman. Those are curses from God, and those curses, they come from God. Why? Because God has spoken a curse over all people who will do those things. When you engage yourself in lesbianism, know that there is a curse that you make in the kingdom of darkness. There is a curse that you make. You invoke those demons of immorality, of lesbianism. When you sleep with a woman, you used to sleep with a woman. Maybe when you are on college, you used to have those desire. That is a curse. You need to break it today in the name of Jesus Christ, and to confess of the shame thing that you used to do. Hallelujah. Let us read in the book of Leviticus, in the book of Leviticus 19:22. Leviticus 19:22. Let us read so that we may understand what we are speaking. Let us read in the name of Jesus. Leviticus 18:22. You know, there are curses. Sexual sin, it is a curse. Sexual sin is a curse. It is not allowed. Let us read Leviticus. Leviticus 18:27. And in your own time, you may read the whole of it. From 24, I can read from 24, in order that we can understand that there are curses that God is saying, curses, they are punishment, they are disaster that God is invoking to all those who will go against his word, or who will disobey. And that is I'm reading Leviticus. I'm reading Leviticus 18, the verses 24. Starting 24. Let me read. All 20. Moreover, you shall not lie carnally with your neighbor's wife to defile yourself with her. That is adultery now. And you shall not let of your descendant pass through the fire to Molech, nor of the descendants pass through the fire to Molech. You shall not profane the name of your God. I am the Lord. You know those Illuminati, when they enter into Illuminati, they enter into a star of fire. They lie down to a star of fire, whereby they call that star. It is a star, a bafflement star. Then they lie there, and then they do that. And you shall not let any one of your descendants pass through the fire. It is they pass through the fire of Tumeresh. 22. You shall not lie with a male as with a woman. Look at that. That is homosexual. Homosexual. You shall not lie with a male as with a woman. It is an abomination. Look at that. It is an abomination. It is a curse. Nor shall you mate with any animal. That is bestiality. You shall not mate with any animal. That is bestiality. That is a curse. To defile yourself with it. You see, when you sleep with such thing, you defile yourself with those curses. Nor shall any woman stand before an animal to mate with it. Even women, they should not mate with the animal. It is perversion. 24. Do not defile yourself with any of those things. For by all those the nation are defiled, which I am casting out before you. Look at that. Because of those things, the nation have been defiled, and because of that things God have casted away. I am casting out before you. You see, for the land is defiled. Therefore, for I visit the punishment of its iniquity upon it, and the land vomit its inhabits. Look at that. God, he say he will punish. He will punish. I punish of its iniquity. You shall therefore keep my status and my judgment, and shall not commit any of abomination either any of your own nation or stranger or dwell among you. For all those abominations the men of the land have done who are before you, and thus the land is defiled. Lest the land vomit you out also when you defile it, as I vomit out the nation that were before you. Look at that. The land will vomit you. What do you understand by the land vomiting you? That is a curse. That is a curse. For whoever commit any of those abominations, the person who commit them shall be cut off from all among my people. You see, they shall be cut off. The Bible says they shall be cut off, meaning it is a curse. They shall be cursed. Hallelujah. So, my dear brother, my sister, that means we should be careful. We should be careful so much to know that those are curses. When you do those sexual intercourse, they are curses, and maybe you repented, but did you disconnect yourself from those curses? Did you disconnect yourself from those spirits? You see, because it is a spirit, and that spirit still will follow you. There was another time that I was meditating, and I was asking myself, today there are children who are born today, and those children, you find that a child is born, and when he is born, he is a man. When he become like 19 years or like 15 years, that man, inside that man, start to behave like a woman. He start to behave like a woman. He want to sleep with other men. You see? And I was wondering, can God create such people? Because God in the beginning is the one who created the people. Is there such people within two parts? He is a transgender. He is a man. When you look at him, he is a man. He have even the beads. He have even the beads. He is a man. But when you look upon what he is doing things like a woman. And he is sleeping with other men. He say he don't have any feeling for women. Because he is a man, but he want to have to sleep with other men. Because he don't have any feeling. He don't have his hormone is of women. And I was wondering, some of the things that happen, how do they happen? That the people are being born when they have a hormone of men, but they are women. Either they have hormone of men when they are women. What happens? And those people, you find them, they are they that are starting this cult.
of LGBT. They are they that are starting this movement of LGBT, of transgender, bisexual, homosexual, gayism. They are they that are starting that movement because they don't have feeling for men. They are men, but they are women, but they don't have feeling for men, but for women. And I was wondering what happened. And I was given a word of wisdom that is as a result, there was a spirit of homosexual in the background. In the background, there was a spirit of homosexual. Maybe their father, maybe their grandfather, maybe they're somewhere they engage in homosexual. They engage men, a man sleeping with a man, a woman sleeping with a woman, and so her children will inherit that same thing when they grow up. You see, those are curses. That is why I'm telling you, we must break those curses. You must break those curses so that your children will not repeat them. Your children will not repeat them, will not be lesbian. Your children will not be homosexual, will not be gay or transgender. We must break them in the name of Jesus. You see, those kind of intercourse, sexual intercourse, which are not allowed by God, they are open door for curses. They are open door for diseases. They are open door for demonic spirit. And sex is being used so much in the kingdom of darkness. Sex is being used so much, is used so much in the kingdom of darkness. For the Bible says, don't you know that whoever sleep with us, we sleep with a prostitute become one. When you meet together, you become one. So you see, it is a curse. You have become one thing. So when you do intercourse with the wrong person or with the beast or with the man, that is, you become one. It is a curse. It is a bound. It is a covenant that you have made. That is why sex is used so much, even by the satanist. They use it to fulfill covenant. They use it to initiate people in the kingdom of darkness. They use it to bound people in their kingdom. They use it to invoke curses upon people. And people, they do not know. Many do not know. Those are curses. Maybe you went for a prostitute. That is a curse. You need to break it in the name of Jesus Christ. Another curse that I want to mention, it is a curse. The curses that come from God. There are other curses, curses that come from God. And those curses that come from God, you see, in the beginning, the first curse came from the book of Genesis, where a woman, when a woman ate that fruit, God cursed her, and she told her that because you have done this and this, I will curse you, that you will feel pain, you will bear children with pain. And that curse, the curse of God, they are very powerful because many of them, they are not revoked. Many of them cannot be revoked. They cannot even be renounced. Many of them, I say many of them, there are some, but like that one, it has never been revoked. Which women today, when they bring children, they don't feel pain. That curse is still there. And the men, they were cursed. That when you eat by your sweat, when you want to eat, or because you will eat the food by the sweat. You see? You receive food by the sweat. You will work hard. That curse is still there today. People are still working. Sweating. I am also sweating. When I go to preach, I sweat. I am working. I am eating in my sweat. So those are curses from God. But now there are those curses that are so bad that kills you. Now those are what I want to speak about. In the book of Deuteronomy 5:9, where we read that and do not bow down to other idol, for God will punish you. I am God that punish the fourth generation, the third generation, punishing the iniquity of your fathers. So that is a curse that came from God, direct from God, that when you do this against this and this, I will curse you. Those are curses that come from God. You see, there are many curses that are written in the scripture, and I want just to take few of them. few of them. Let us go in the book of Deuteronomy 5. Deuteronomy 28. Deuteronomy 28. And on your own time also you can read all of it. And the Bible says this. Look at this. He start 28. He started by blessing. He started. God started by releasing a blessing, and he said, "Now it shall come to pass if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God to observe careful at His command, which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above all nations of the earth, and all the blessings shall come upon you and overtake you, because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Blessed shall you be in the city, and blessed shall you be in the country." You see? Because when you hear the word of God, when you obey the commandment of God, the God will bless you. He said, blessed shall be the fruit of your body, blessed shall be the basket of you, blessed shall be when you come in, and blessed shall be when you go. Look at that. Those are blessings of obedience. Hallelujah. The Lord will cause your enemy who rise against you to defeat you before your face. Look at that. Then they shall come out against you one way and flee from you before you seven ways. Why? Because of blessing of obedience. The Lord will command a blessing on you, on your storehouse in which you set your hand. The Lord will establish you as a holy people. Now when you continue like this, now you go to curses. And those are the curses now. 15 say. Deuteronomy 28:15. Now we are speaking about curses from God. There are curses that come from disobedience. So when you disobey the word of God, no, there are curses. That is why we emphasize people on preaching about the holiness, preaching truth, preaching righteousness, preaching against the disobedience, preaching against sin. Why? Because there are curses that come on a result of disobedience. 15 say, "But it shall come to pass, if you do not obey the voice of the Lord your God, to observe careful all His commandment and His statutes, which I command you today, that all those curses will come upon you and overtake you." Look at that. He say, "Cursed shall you be in the city, and cursed shall you be in the country. Cursed shall be your basket. Cursed shall be in the fruit of your body, and produce of your rod, the increase of your cattle, the offspring of your flock." Look at that. He is cursing the fruit of his body. So he's cursing the children. He's cursing even the cattle that you see some people, they are cursed that even the cattle, they cannot multiply cattle. They cannot keep cattle. When they keep cattle, they become barren. They cannot produce. They cannot multiply. They are curses. Let us seek curses. Let us seek them. Let us seek blessing, not a curse. Curses, he say, curses, curse shall be the fruit of your body. Curse shall be when you come in. And the Lord will set you cursing, confusion, and rebuke in all that you set your hand to do, until you are destroyed, until you perish quickly. Look at that. Until you perish quickly. That means premature death. Premature death. Why? Because of curses of disobedience. When you disobey the will of God, when you disobey God, maybe you had promised God something, but you did not fulfill it. That is also a curse. If you don't fulfill it, it is a curse. Unless you repent quickly, the Lord will make plague cling to you until He has consumed you from the land which you are going to possess. Plague. There are plagues like Corona. It is a curse from God. You see, the Lord will strike you with conception, with the fever, even with some of the sickness, with the fever, with the inflammation, with a severe burning fever, with the sword, with the scorching, and with the mildew, they shall pass you until you perish, and your heaven which are over you, your head shall be bronze, and the earth which is under you shall be iron. You see, when he said that the earth which is under you shall be iron, that means that whatever you plant, it is like planting in iron. Nothing will grow. You will not enjoy it. There are many curses that God has spoken here. Yeah? There are many curses that God has spoken here. Curses of even sickness. There are even tumors here. He said, "The Lord will strike you with boils of Egypt, with the tumors, with the scab, and with the itch from which you cannot be healed." Look at that. From which you cannot be healed. Tumors. Today people are growing tumors which they cannot be healed. Those are the result of disobedience. Some may be going through disobedience of their forefathers, disobedience of their mother or their father. Because they are in the lineage, they are the fourth generation, the third generation. Let us not joke with the curses. He said, there are many curses which God has spoken here. And he said, there will be even the curses of miscarriage. The curses of miscarriage, they are here. The Lord strike you in the knee and on the legs with severe bones. He will strike even their bone with the boils. He will crush them. You shall carry much seed to the field, but gather little. Look at that. That you shall carry much seed to the field, but gather very little. You invest in your job very. You invest a lot, but you gather a little. You harvest a little. Your income is little. Some of things here are curses from God. Let us not ignore some of the things. You shall plant vineyard, tend, but you shall not neither drink nor wine nor gather the grapes, for the worm shall eat them. You shall have olive tree through all the territory, but you shall not anoint yourself with the oil, for your oil shall drop off. Look at that. Planting, but somebody else will eat. You shall beget son and daughter, but they shall not be yours, for they shall go into the captivity. Look at that. Bearing children, but those children, they shall become captivity. They shall become slave of other men, slave of other people. Look at that. That you don't even enjoy the relationship with your family, with your children, because they have become captive. Let us not joke with the disobedience. Let us not joke with the sin, my dear brother, my sister. Sin. This job, disobedience before God. He continued to say, locusts shall consume all your tree and produce of your land. Even locusts. Locusts, that is a curse from God. Locusts shall consume all your tree and produce of your land. Like our Kenya have been devoured by locusts. Africa, by locusts. Why are those things coming? They are curses from God. Curses of disobedience. There's something that we have not done. There's something that the kings, the leaders have not done that they should do. The alien, moreover, all the curses shall come upon you, pursue, overtake you until you are destroyed, because you did not obey the voice of the Lord your God to keep commandment and his statutes which he commanded you. And they shall be upon you for a sign and a wonder on your descended forever. Look at that. Now, the worst thing he said, they shall be on you on your descended forever. Not only your descended forever. That is why I told you that you may be going some certain curse, but it was due to your father, due to your mother, due to your grandfather. There are curses that come from God. So let us be careful. Let us be careful, because God is God. He's the same today, yesterday, and forever. And his word speak true. What he say in the word, it can manifest on your life. No matter you are a Christian, no matter you are born again, no matter you are baptized, no matter you have the Holy Spirit, if you don't repent and disconnect yourself from those curses, you cannot get free. You cannot go well, because the word of God will fight against you. There is another curse that many people ignore. That is in the book of Malachi. Malachi 3:9. Let us hear. Maybe you ignore this curse, but those are curses now from God. You may fight against curses from witchcraft. You may fight against curses from witchcraft, from traditional. You may fight all those curses now, but there are curses that come from God. And those one, if you don't repent and start fulfill them, it cannot be well with you. Malachi 3:11. I want to look for that. Let me read in the name of Jesus. The Bible says this. Will a man, Malachi 3:8, starting 3:8. Will a man rob God? Yet you have robbed me. But you say, in what have we robbed you? In tithes and offering. Look at that. In what way have we robbed you? In tithes and offering. Offering and tithes. You are cursed with a curse. Look at that. Because you have not offered, you have not brought the tithe. You are under a curse with a curse. You are cursed with a curse. For you have robbed me, even the whole nation. Bring all the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. And try me now in this, say the Lord of hosts, if I will not open for you such widows, for you the widows of heaven, and pour out for you such blessing, that there shall be no more room enough to receive. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. God will rebuke the devourer for your sake, because of tithe. So that he will not destroy you. He will not destroy the fruit of your ground. Nor shall the vine fail to bear the fruit for you in the field, say the Lord of hosts. And all nations will call you blessed, for you will be delightful land, says the Lord of hosts. Look at that. that God will rebuke the devourer because of fulfilling offering and tithes.
Yeah, many people say, Jesus Christ, he died and it is finished. No tithing, no offering, no breaking of curse, no living of holiness. It is finished. You are deceiving yourself because the word of God must be fulfilled. Must be fulfilled in the name of Jesus Christ. Those are part of the curses that come from God. That is why you hear some people say, my business, my hot is going away. What? And you wonder, do you tithe? Do you tithe? Because if you don't tithe, God is saying here that, and I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, so that he will not destroy the fruit of your ground. So those who tithe, God say, I will rebuke the devourer. Those who offer, I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, so that he will not destroy the fruit of your ground. So, thief are taking my thing. I am losing money. My money is being wasted. Wasted in sickness. Wasted in medicine. When I get the income, I don't know how those money end up. What is happening? Are you fulfilling the word of God? Or are you fighting with the God curses? Are there God curses that are operating on your life? Let us look upon it, so that you may not say that I have not told you what is happening. When you fulfill the word of God, you have now the right to ask God, why is this happening? And I'm fulfilling the word. And God will rebuke the devourer for your sake. But how will God rebuke the devourer when you are a thief, a robber, stealing from God? Be careful and learn away, free from those curses from God, because they are terrible. They are terrible, my dear brother. Let me now read again in the book of Proverbs 3:33. Proverbs 3:33, and we are coming to conclude, so that now we may come to deliver us prayers. I will show you I will teach you in step by step how to get delivered and how to break them in Jesus' name. Proverbs 3:33. The Bible says, the curse of the Lord is on the house of the wicked, but he blesses the home of the just. Look at that. That the curse of the wicked, the curse of the Lord is on the house of the wicked. The curse of the Lord is on the house of the wicked, but he blesses the home of the just. What does that mean? That the curse of the Lord is upon those who are wicked, is upon their house, that their house is upon the curse. That is why it is not good to stay with the wicked people, because if you go to their house, the house of the wicked people, know that the curse of God is under them. The curse of God is hanging over them. It is like dwelling in Sodom and Gomorrah. So cry for mercy. Cry for mercy when you are in that country, when you are in that home, or when you are in that house, because God says that the curse of the Lord is upon the house of the wicked, but the blessing of the Lord are upon the just. The just shall be blessed by God. That is what the word of God says. My dear brother and my sister, those are curses that come from God, and also he is the same God that blesses. For he said that if you follow God and obey him, God have put blessing for those who follow him and for those who obey his commandment. But for those who disobey him, he have put a curse. If you follow God, if you don't worship God, if you don't follow, if you don't obey him, he have put a curse. He have put death. So it is for you to choose death or life, a curse or a blessing. If you follow God, I want to finish up. There's another certain scripture here in the book of Genesis. The book of Genesis 12:3. The book of Genesis 12:3. There is another thing that is spoken here. There's another thing that is spoken here. The curses from God and the blessing of God. The Bible says, it starts from 1. Now the Lord has said to Abraham, get out of your country, from your family, and from your father's house, to a land that I wish to show you. I will make you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name great. And you shall be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curse you. And in all the family
of the earth shall be blessed. Look at that. If you notice here, there is a bless, there's a blessing, and there is also a curse. God say, I will bless those who bless you. You see? And I will curse him who curse you. This is a blessing. This is a blessing. This is the inheritance of those who fear God, of those who walk with God. This is an inheritance of those who serve God, those who worship God. I will bless those who bless you. It is for you. If you bless somebody that is blessed by God, if you bless a person of God or a man of God or a woman of God, if you bless him, God will bless you. But if you curse that man of God or that woman of God, God will also curse you. That is what God says. I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curse you. So that is why we are not told to point the servants of God or to curse them. Because if you curse them and God has blessed them, therefore you will deal with God. God will curse you. But if you bless them, you also will be blessed. It is like nation of Israel. God said that those who will bless Israel, God will also bless them. But those who will curse Israel, God will curse them. So you see, that do not touch you, the anointed, anointed nation, anointed man of God, anointed woman of God. If you point her, if you curse, you will get a cursing. If you bless, you will get blessing. Look at that. So those are the curses that I was speaking from God, that are released by God. Hallelujah. Now I want us to pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I know that you have known those curses that may be operating in your life. And to break those curses, number one, we must repent. It is repentance. It is whereby you repent and say, oh God, forgive me. Forgive me, God, because I am a sinner. Forgive me. I did not know that what I did in many years, it is a sin. Repenting the sin of your forefathers, repenting the sin of your traditional, repenting the sin of generation, repenting the sin of sexual intercourse, repenting the sin of disobedience. When you repent those sins, then God will cleanse you. He will forgive you in the name of Jesus Christ. You see? Oh, the blood of Jesus. I want us to repent in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. It washes white as snow. Oh, the blood of Jesus. I want you to feel guilty of your sin, guilty of the shame that you have committed, so that we may now repent together in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Right where you are, I want you to lift up your hand in the name of Jesus Christ as I read you into repentance. I want to read you into repentance in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. I want to read you into repentance wherever you are. I want you to repeat those repentance prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, mighty Jesus, I come before you. I have risen to the word of God, and I repent today of all disobedience that I have caused. I repent of bowing down to other idols. I repent from all sexual intercourse. I repent for lesbianism. I repent for bestiality. I repent for gayism, homosexual. I repent for fornication. I repent for adultery in Jesus' name. Lord, I repent for the disobedience of your word, for the disobedience of following your commandment. I repent in the name of Jesus. Forgive me in Jesus' name. I repent in Jesus' name. Now that you have repented in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I want you now
to renounce all those generational curses in the name of Jesus Christ. You will repeat after me with your heart, with your tongue. For when you shall be repeating those words, there will be power of God who will come to break them in Jesus' name. For there is power in confession with the tongue. For you are the one who made a covenant with your soul. Therefore, when you confess, you will break them in Jesus' name. Repeat after me in Jesus' name. I renounce generational curses in the name of Jesus Christ and the blood of Jesus. I renounce all the spoken word of shedding blood. I renounce them and I break them by the blood of Jesus and by the name of Jesus. I renounce the death curses in the name of Jesus. I renounce and I disconnect myself from evil celebration, from death initiation, from Halloween celebration. I disconnect my soul in the name of Jesus and in the blood of Jesus. Repeat. I renounce all tattoo initiation in Jesus' name. I renounce the death initiation, the death celebration, the death covenant. I renounce it and I break it by the blood of Jesus and the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce every curses in my life in the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. I renounce name curses, my name curses. I renounce it in the name of Jesus. If your name is Simon, if your name, the traditional name, just name that name in Jesus' name. Say and put your name. I renounce the name Geshinga. I renounce every curse in the name Geshinga, in the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. I renounce the generational curses. I disconnect them in the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. I break and disconnect my name from blood sacrifice in the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus Christ. I renounce and break every evil word spoken over my life in the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. I break down all spoken word against my life, against my health, against my destiny, against my family, against my life, in the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. I break down, I renounce every altars of darkness, altars of witchcraft, altars of wizard, altars of satanist, altars of false prophet. I renounce them and I break them in the name of Jesus Christ and the blood of Jesus. I disconnect my soul from every demonic initiation. I disconnect my soul from every demonic initiation in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. I renounce and I repent all sexual sin. I renounce and I repent all sexual sin. Sex before marriage. I repent, I renounce, and I break all demonic covenant in the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. I break down all covenant of sexual sin in my life, in my children, in my destiny, in my seed, in the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. I renounce fornication. I renounce bestiality. I renounce homosexual in the name of Jesus and by the blood of Jesus. I renounce masturbation. I renounce prostitution in the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. I renounce in Jesus' name. I repent and I break those curses in Jesus' name. Oh Jesus, I break now every curses over my life. All curses, I break all curses in my life in the name of Jesus and by the blood of Jesus. I possess the blessing of the blood of Jesus in Jesus' name. Say that. I possess the blessing of the blood of Jesus in Jesus' name. By your stripes I am healed in Jesus' name. By your stripes I am blessed in Jesus' name. By your death you took away my curses and you brought blessing in my life. I possess those blessings from your blood, from your covenant. In the name of Jesus, I am blessed in Jesus' name. Bless my name. Bless my life. Bless my marriage. Bless my children. In the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. Now I declare in Jesus' name. Repeat those words after me in Jesus' name. Declare with your tongue. The Bible says that the words has power. Words has power. What you will speak has power. So what you will invoke, what you will say has power. Declare through your tongue. I bless my life in the name of Jesus and in the blood of Jesus. I bless my children in the name of Jesus and by the blood of Jesus. I bless my name. I bless my destiny in the name of Jesus and in the and by the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I bless myself in the name of the Lord Jesus. Bless yourself in the name of the Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name, I do pray and believe. Amen. 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 I feel power of God right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Let me pray for you right now in Jesus' name. Lift up your hand, your soul, and let me pray for you. Mighty Father, Lord of Lord, the King of Glory, the Lord Jesus Christ, I come before you, I glorify your name, and I give you all the glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Right now, your people have renounced. They have renounced sexual sin. They have renounced fornication. They have renounced polygamy. They have renounced witchcraft. They have renounced idol worship. They have renounced all kind of sin and demonic celebration. They have renounced and repented their sin. Right now, I want to challenge you, devil. I want to challenge you in the name of Jesus. Having that these people has confessed and they have repented, I command you, you demonic spirit, living in the soul of this brother, in the soul of this brother, in the soul of this sister, I command you in the name of Jesus, come out, you have no place over him. Come out, you have no place over her. In the name of Jesus, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Every curses over your life, I break it in Jesus' name. Every curses in your family, in your marriage, in your name, I break it in the name of Jesus. Curses of death, curses of premature death, curses of anger, curses of bitterness, curses of abortion, curses of polygamy, curses of miscarriage, curses of drunkenness, curses of name, I break them in the name of Jesus. Curses of poverty,
Curses, I rebuke them. I disconnect them over your life right now. In the name of Jesus, mighty Father, I want to declare, you demonic spirit, you spiritual husband, spiritual woman, spiritual husband, spiritual wife, that you have been tormenting the life of this brother, the life of this sister. I command you right now to come out in the name of Jesus. I disconnect you in Jesus' name. Having by he, she, or her, renounce and confess, I command you have no power. You have no power. I break down your covenant, the covenant of sexual sin, the covenant of marine kingdom, the covenant of sexual dreams. I break that. I disconnect that dreams in the name of Jesus. I break them in the name of Jesus. And by the blood of Jesus Christ, I loose your life. I loose your life. I loose your life, human. I loose your life, human. I loose your life. I loose your life. Ruse, in the name of Jesus, I set you free by power of the Holy Spirit, by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, by the blood of Jesus, and by the covenant of the blood of Jesus. I break down all demonic covenant, witchcraft covenant, in Jesus' name. Mighty Father, every word that has been spoken against your people, against this brother, against this sister, Lord, I disconnect and I break down every evil curses. The word that has been cast, the evil words that have been cast by witchcraft, by the false prophet, I use this word in Jesus' name. I bless them through the word, O Lord, through your word. For you say that those who will bless by your name, by your name, Lord Jesus, they will be blessed. Now I bless them in the name of Jesus. And I break down every curses over their family, their children, their health, their destiny, in the name of Jesus, over their name. They break it in Jesus' name. And I declare a blessing, O God, over their life, in the name of Jesus, through the name of Jesus Christ and the blood of Jesus Christ. Mighty King of glory, Lord Jesus, separate even nations, our nations from curses. Separate our nation from curses. Separate our nations from curses, O God, from the praise, Lord, as we continue to repent in the name of Jesus Christ. Mighty Father, by the blessing of the Lord Jesus, by the blessing of the Holy Spirit, I pray that, Lord, your people will enjoy your blessing in Jesus' name. I deactivate, Lord, life upon their life. I activate life upon their life, and I deactivate death upon their life in the name of Jesus. I deactivate death over your life in Jesus' name. I disconnect the demonic spirit, diseases over your life, over your health. I declare transformation, healing over your body, healing over your marriage, healing over your spirit, healing over your spiritual life in Jesus' name. And I activate life and the blessing of God in the name of Jesus Christ. We do pray and even believe. Amen, 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 amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for your word. Thank you, Jesus, for your fellowship. Thank you, Jesus, for the word that you have given us. Thank you, oh God. We glorify your name. We praise you. We worship you, Jehovah. We say that there is none like you in the name of Jesus. All the glory we give unto you in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody clap for Jesus wherever you are. Clap for Jesus in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For it is over. It is over. In Jesus' name, you are released in Jesus' name. Let me tell you, faith is not is a substance that is not seen. Faith is to believe without seeing. I am not there, you are. You cannot touch me. But by faith, you can believe. And the word that I have spoken, they can transform your life, heal you, deliver you. Because faith is believing what you don't see. Faith is spiritual. Faith is untouchable. But you believe in Jesus' name. So those words that I have spoken, those words that you have listened, they can transform your life. If only you believe, don't need another deliverance. You only need faith to believe and to be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Get the end time writings of Apostle Simon Gishinga a humble end-time messenger with an apostolic wisdom of the Word of God and end-times revelations, preparing the bride of Christ for the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ in complete holiness and righteousness. Go to Play Store Android application and search Apostle Simon Gishinga. Click and download the application. All messages are offline once you download them. Receive back the ancient Word of God, reviving the saints for the kingdom of God by inspired living Word of God. Search Apostle Simon Gishinga on Play Store application.